contribution.
Thank you very much.
To be fair, I'll tell you when 1.5 minutes is up to give Mr. Swan the opportunity to fill the other half.
Thank you very much.
Sorry. Is that better?
Yeah, thanks.
Right, I am very strict on timings on public speaking, but I will not start the clock until you press that button on the right and you utter your first word.
My name is Richard Endacott. I'm the Vice Chairman of the Westlands Residents Association. I've been asked by Thais Oliveira, a resident of the Willows, to speak on her behalf tonight. In the 30 years that my family have been associated with the good people of the Willows, I cannot remember another planning application which has caused so much anxiety within this community. First point, this is an inappropriate development in the green belt within the 8 metres buffer of the River Thames. The mooring of marine bollards and rubbish bin enclosures would be more intrusive and spoil the view to and from the river. 7 of the 25 sheds will be replaced by rubbish bin enclosures, which tend to get dirty, smelly and accumulate rubbish around, making it an undesirable feature of the riverbank. The applicant fails to make a case for very special circumstances, as this is not an essential operational or engineering requirement, and the moorings have been functional for over 70 years. Digging a trench for BT cables, water and drainage would create an infrastructure similar to those required by houses. Boats must be self-sufficient away from the moorings. There is therefore ambiguity in this application as to the nature of development, as to whether this is a traditional boat or a floating house. The applicant has tried it on many occasions over the past 20 years to put floating houses on the moorings. The removal of galvanised posts put boaters' lives at risk. These are required to prevent boats from coming onto land during floods and capsizing when the water recedes. Reducing the number of moorings from 33 to 15 is against the Environment Agency and local housing policies. This represents a 55%. This represents a reduction of 55% on the number of residential moorings in the park. There is no justification for this. This application should be rejected in its current form to ensure the openness of the green belt and retention of open spaces, which is so important to park residents, local